Good morning to all. This is Nagumira. Our subject is PPSC for first civil. In that fifth unit, a last topic that is functions. Okay, na? So fifth unit consists of three chapters. In that two chapters are completed. Coming to our last chapter, nothing but third chapter, that is functions. Okay. Okay, na? Today's our topic is functions. Yes, what is the meaning of function first? Simply, here a function is a group of statements. A function is a group of statements that can perform some special task in the program. That is the meaning of function. So simply we can call as a function is a subprogram. Function is a subprogram in the program. It can perform some task in the C program. That is the meaning of a function. Okay, na? Here every C program at least consists of one function. Okay, na? Here in C language, program has at least one function. For example, if you take main function, every C program must consist of main function. That means every C program consists of at least one function. Example is main function. Without main function, there is no C program. We can't execute any program without main function. Okay, na? So simply here every C program at least consists of one function, that is example, that is the main function. Okay, na? Here simply there are two types of functions are there in addition. Okay, na? A part of main function, there are two different types of functions are there. What are those? A library function. Next one is user defined functions. Okay, na? First one is library functions. And next one is user-defined functions. Okay, na? Yes, what is the meaning of library functions? So library functions we discussed. Okay, na? So manam chala classes nunchi chala first unit second unit cheptunnam namandi. Yes, what is the meaning of library functions? Here library functions are predefined functions. Okay, na? So these functions are developed at the time of C software was developed. Okay, na? So here the most popular library functions are nothing but printf, scanf, getS, putS, okay, na? Floor, seal, for example, mathematical functions, okay, sqrt, okay, na? String functions. These all are different types of library functions. Okay, na? So here, for example, if you take scanf, printf, getS, putS, okay, and these all predefined functions are available in our one header file, that is stdio.h. okay, na? If you take mathematical functions, what are those? For example, sqrt, tan, sine, these type. Okay, and these all predefined functions are available in our math.h. if you take string functions, string length, string concatenation, okay, string compare, like that. Okay, na? So these all our string functions are available in our one header file, that is string.h. So simply here library functions are nothing but predefined functions, okay, na? Such as scanf, printf, getS, putS, seal, floor, etc. Okay, na? So this is nothing but our library functions. Coming to our second type of function, what are those? User defined functions. Okay, this is the main and the user defined functions. Okay, na? Here user-defined functions are some types of the functions. These functions are created by the programmer, nothing but user. Okay, na? Using our library functions. Okay, na? So simply here, user-defined functions are another type of functions. These functions are developed by the user. Okay, na? User means manamenandi. Manam kosam develop chese. Functions name user defined functions. So these user defined functions are developed with the help of library functions, and so that we can use it many times. What is the main object of user defined functions? Here the main object of user defined functions are we can use it many times. It reduces the complexity of a big program and optimization of a code. That is the main advantage of our user defined functions. What are those? First one is it can reusable. Reusable means once develop, but we can use it n number of times. Okay, na? And next one is reduce the complexity. Reduce the complexity of big program. What is the meaning of that? Big program means, for example, functions lack on without functions. For example, if we develop a program, the length of the program is high, but with the help of functions, the length of the program may be reduced, and also optimize the code. Here, optimize is nothing but simplicity. Simplify. Okay, program code is simplify with the help of our user-defined functions. Okay, na? So simply we can call as here functions are two types only. So this diagram, okay, na? Here functions are two types. What are those? Here library functions are the user-defined functions. Library function means here these functions are developed at the time of C software was developed. That is the meaning of library functions. Okay, na? Mari evaru develop chesaru deenni? Here library functions are developed by the C creators. That means C software evaru develop chesaru vallu ee library functions ni use chesaru. Here our user defined functions, what is the meaning of your user defined functions? Here user defined functions are created by the creating by the user, ante manam mana kosam develop chestuntam by using library functions. So simply there are two types of function. Library functions, next one is user defined functions. Okay, na? Now coming to our advantages of our functions. Okay, na? Advantages of functions. Yes, konni cheppam andi emi advantages konni cheppam. First one is reusable and cheppam. Okay, na? Next one is reduce the complexity of the program cheppam. And next one is optimize the code and cheppam. So apart from this, there are different advantages of functions are list out. First one is, okay, na? With the help of function, we can avoid rewriting same logic or code again and again in the program. That is the main advantage. What is the meaning of this? Here, this particular point says that here, with the help of functions, we can avoid rewriting the same logic again and again in the program. That means here we can create a function and then we can use it n number of times. We need not to create again and again in the program. Okkasari maatrame create chestamandi enni saarlu aina mana programs lo use cheskovachu. That is the main object of our function. Now next advantage is we can call C functions any number of times in the program and from any place in the program. Now what it says, so here one function is created and saved in anywhere in the system. Here that function is called in any place of the program. Ante function save chesi ekkado save chestamandi danni manam a program lo enni saarlu ekkada kavalna sare danni use chestundo undochu. This is another advantage of this our functions. Okay, na? Next one, we can track large C program easily when it divide into multiple functions. That's what is the meaning of this. Here function is nothing but subprogram definition. So definition says function is a subprogram. That means, for example, large program ni manam em chestam, here large program is divided into some parts using these functions. So in some large program is some parts ga divide cheyadam valla use enti ekkadaina error ostund ankonde aa error ni easy ga find out cheyochu. That is the main advantage. Okay, na? And next one, reusability is the main architecture of C function. Yes, this is the main advantage of coach and reusability. That means function okka sari create chestam but we can use multiple number of times in any program. Okay, na? So ఒకసారి క్రియేట్ చేసిన దాన్ని మనం ఎన్నిసార్లు ఏ ప్రోగ్రామ్ కావాలంటే ఆ ప్రోగ్రామ్ లోకి యూజ్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. దట్ ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ రీయూజబిలిటీ. ఓకేనా? నౌ ద లాస్ట్ వన్ ఈజ్ ఫంక్షన్ కాలింగ్ ఈజ్ ఆల్వేస్ ఓవర్ హెడ్ ఇన్ సి ప్రోగ్రామ్. సో ఫంక్షన్ కాల్స్ అనే వాటిని యూజ్ చేసుకుని ఏ ఫంక్షన్ ఎక్కడి నుంచి అయితే కాల్ చేసుకుంటూ ఉండొచ్చు. ఓకేనా? సో దీస్ ఆల్ ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్ అడ్వాంటేజెస్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్. ఓకేనా? దీస్ ఆల్ ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్ అడ్వాంటేజెస్ ఆఫ్ సి ఫంక్షన్స్. Only C functions, any language, if you take any language, C, Java, okay, C, C, plus Java, so A functions and A language answer, A functions answer, way use, okay, na? These all are advantages of our functions. Now, this question, define functions, explain డిఫరెంట్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్ విత్ ఇట్స్ అడ్వాంటేజ్ అని ఇస్తాండి, విత్ ఇట్ అడ్వాంటేజెస్ అని ఇస్తారు. అంటే ఫంక్షన్ డెఫినేషన్ రాయాలి, నెక్స్ట్ వన్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్ రాయాలి, నెక్స్ట్ వన్ అడ్వాంటేజెస్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్ రాయాలి. సో 7 మార్క్స్ ఇస్తారండి. ఓకేనా? సో సింపుల్లీ ఏం రాస్తారండి? సింపుల్లీ ఫంక్షన్ డెఫినేషన్ రాస్తారు. వాట్ ఇస్ ది మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్? హియర్ ఫంక్షన్ ఈజ్ ఏ గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ స్టేట్మెంట్స్ ఇన్ ది ప్రోగ్రామ్. సింప్లీ వీ కెన్ కాల్ యాజ్ ఫంక్షన్ ఈజ్ ఏ సబ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఇన్ ది సి ప్రోగ్రామ్. ఇట్ పర్ఫార్మ్ సమ్ టాస్క్. ఓకేనా? ఇట్ పర్ఫార్మ్ సమ్ స్పెషల్ టాస్క్. సి ప్రోగ్రామ్ కన్సిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎట్ లీస్ట్ వన్ ఫంక్షన్. ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఈజ్ మెయిన్. ఓకేనా? హియర్ దేర్ ఆర్ టూ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్. దోస్ ఆర్ లైబ్రరీ ఫంక్షన్స్ అండ్ యూజర్ డిఫైన్డ్ ఫంక్షన్స్. అంటే ఇప్పుడు రాస్తారు, ఇట్లా రాస్తారు. ఓకేనా? సో నెక్స్ట్ వన్ అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్ అని ఇవన్నీ రాస్తారండి. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ అబౌట్ అవర్ అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఆస్పెక్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్ అండి. ఆస్పెక్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్ అంటే ఫంక్షన్స్ ని మనం హౌ టు క్రియేట్ ఏ ఫంక్షన్, హౌ టు యూజ్ ఏ ఫంక్షన్ ఇన్ ది సి ప్రోగ్రామ్. ఓకేనా? ఆస్పెక్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్. సో సింపుల్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఫంక్షన్స్, ఫంక్షన్ ఆస్పెక్ట్. దీన్ని మనం ఏమంటామంటే పార్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్ అండి. ఓకేనా? లేదా కాంపోనెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్ ఎట్లయినా అడగవచ్చు. ఓకేనా? కాంపోనెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్. సో ఇదే క్వశ్చన్ ని ఓకేనా, డిఫైన్ ఫంక్షన్, ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ది డిఫరెంట్ ఆస్పెక్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్ అడగవచ్చు. లేదా డిఫైన్ ఫంక్షన్, ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ఫంక్షన్ కాన్సెప్ట్స్ అన్న రాసుకోవచ్చు. ఇదే రాసుకుంటా. ఓకేనా? లేదా డిఫైన్ ఫంక్షన్, ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ డిఫరెంట్ కాంపోనెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్ అన్న ఇదే రాస్తారు. ఓకేనా? హియర్ సో సింప్లీ దెర్ ఆర్ 3 aspects ఆఫ్ సి ఫంక్షన్స్. నాట్ ఓన్లీ సి, సి ప్లస్ ప్లస్, జావా. ఓకేనా? ఆల్ ఫంక్షన్స్ ఆర్ 3 aspects. సో సింప్లీ హియర్ దెర్ ఆర్ 3 aspects ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్. దెర్ ఆర్ 3 aspects ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షన్స్. వాట్ ఆర్ దోస్? ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఈజ్ ఫంక్షన్ డిక్లరేషన్, నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈజ్ ఫంక్షన్ కాలింగ్, నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈజ్ ఫంక్షన్ డెఫినేషన్. ఓకేనా? దీస్ 3 are must ఇన్ ఫంక్షన్ సి ప్రోగ్రామ్, ఇన్ ఫంక్షన్ ఇన్ ఏ సి ప్రోగ్రామ్. ఓకేనా? ఫంక్షన్ ఇన్ ఏ సి ప్రోగ్రామ్ కన్సిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ 3 components. దీస్ 3 are must టు క్రియేట్ ఏ ఫంక్షన్. వాట్ ఆర్ దోస్? ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఈజ్ ఫంక్షన్ డిక్లరేషన్, నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈజ్ ఫంక్షన్ కాల్, నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈజ్ ఫంక్షన్ డెఫినేషన్. ఈ 3 అర్థమైతేనే మనకి ఈ ఫంక్షన్ అంటే ఏంటో, ఆ ఫంక్షన్ ఎట్లా వర్క్ అవుతుంది, ఇవన్నీ అర్థమవుతుంటాయండి. ఓకేనా? సో సింప్లీ హియర్ దెర్ ఆర్ 3 aspects ఆఫ్ సి ఫంక్షన్స్. కమింగ్ టు అవర్ ఫస్ట్ వన్, దట్ ఈస్ ఫంక్షన్ డిక్లరేషన్, నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఫంక్షన్ కాలింగ్, నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఫంక్షన్ డెఫినేషన్. ఓకేనా? అదండి. కమింగ్ టు అవర్ ఫస్ట్ వన్, దట్ ఈస్ ఫంక్షన్ డిక్లరేషన్. These all are related to our user-defined functions. Library functions are user-defined functions. Okay, na? So, to create a user-defined function, these 3 are must. What are those? Okay, na? Declaration. Next one is calling. Next one is definition. Okay, na? Function declaration, function calling. Next one is function definition. I'm coming to our first one. What is the meaning of function declaration? Okay, na? Yes. Here function declaration is must. Function declaration is a must that is declared globally in a C program. Globally means that is before the main. Okay, na? Before the main. In the main, that is local. Before the main, that is the global. So simply function declaration is a must that is declared globally in a C program that tells the compiler about the function name and function parameters and also function return type. Adalli okay na? So what function declaration consists? Function declaration consists of function name, function parameter and return type. Okay na? So function declaration consists of 3 components. And what are those? Function. First one is function name. Next one is function parameter. Next one is function type. These 3 are available in our function declaration. That is before main. Nothing but globally declared function declaration. Okay, na? So what is the meaning of function name? A function name is nothing but, for example, if we want to create a simple function, that is add. that is add. So I want to create a simple function that is add two numbers. Now here function name is like add. Function name is nothing but like add. Okay, now function name is nothing but add. Now function parameters are nothing but, so what is the main object of the particular function? To add two numbers. So here the parameters are nothing but two numbers, that is int x, int y, like that. Int x, comma, int y, like that. Those are parameters. Now return type. Return type is nothing but, for example, return type is nothing but, here it may be a void, it may be integer, it may be a float. So the result of the function, the result here, the return type is depends upon the result of the function. So for example, I want to perform addition of two numbers. The result may be addition of, the result may be integer. So here the return type is int. Now simply, what is the declaration of that particular function? Int add of a comma b. Okay, now int add of a comma b. So this is nothing but declaration of a function. Okay, now coming to our next aspect, that is function call. Yes, function call can be declared from anywhere in the program. Function call can be declared from anywhere in the program. The parameter list not differ in function calling and function declaration. What it says, the function parameter like must not differ in function calling and function declaration. We must pass the same number of functions as it is declared in the function declaration. Yes, so simply here, what is the meaning of function calling? Function calling is nothing but that is called from anywhere in the program. Generally, this function call is in the main program. When function call is appear in the main program, it stops the main program execution and goes to function definition. Function definition means, now coming to our function definition third aspect. Now function definition takes you to other function calling a lyrical chapter today. Now function definition, this is the third aspect, this is the main part. And here function definition consists the actual statement which are to be executed. It is most important aspect to which the control comes when the function is called. Okay, here we must notice that only one value can be returned from function. What it says, so function definition is nothing but this is the actual part of the function. This is not in the main. The function definition may be before the main or after the main. Function definition can be defined before the main or after the main. Okay, now so this is a subprogram actually. So when a function call is appear in the main function, then our main program stop its execution and come to function definition. Now what function definition consists? Here the function definition consists of main logic. Now coming to our example, what is our example? Int add of a comma b. So what is the main object of my program? To add two numbers. How to add? So c equal to a plus b. Okay, c equal to a plus b. Printf, the addition of two numbers or something c like that. So these all are the main logic is defined in function definition. Okay, so the main logic is defined in function definition. So main, after function definition complete, what happened? The result is carried and this result is goes into function call. Came out me function call epudaithe execution complete ayyindo deeni result ekkada theesukelabadutundi function calling daggara theesukelutundi. So function call ekkada undi? Main function lo undi. So main function execute avutunappudu function call. So function call execute ayi aa tarvata function definition execute avutundi. Aa tarvata function definition execute ayi na original result anedi malli main function loki carry avutundi. So main function nunchi nozzle display a program definite opening. So this is called as function definition. So simply here function consists of three major part. What are those? First one is function declaration, that is globally declared, nothing but before the main. Okay, na function call is nothing but generally function call is appearing in main function. Function definition. This function definition is after the main. Okay, na after the main or before the main. Okay, na actually the body of the function is function definition. Okay, now coming to our syntaxes of these three aspects. What are those? First one is function declaration. How our function declaration is there? So the syntax is return type function name of arguments. Return type function name, that is arguments. That is the syntax of our function declaration. Okay, example is how return type, nothing but int. Int may be return type, okay. So function name, that is add. Add is my function name of parameters. What are those? A comma B. Okay, example. Now coming to our function call. Function call. How we can create a function call? The syntax of the function call is nothing but function name of arguments. Okay, function name of arguments. That is, for example, function name, what is that? Add of A comma B. Like that, add of X comma Y. Like that. Okay, that is the function call. So function declaration is globally, that is before the main. Okay, now next one is function call is in the main function. Like that, function definition. What is the meaning of function definition? Here function definition can be created using the syntax, that is return type. Okay, now return type function name of argument list. Okay, now argument list. So function body. Now simply what is this? Okay, now function definition. Function definition is at before the main or after the main. Okay, now how do we define a function definition? Return type space function name of argument list. Now open brace function body, close brace, nothing but function close. So for example, if you want to create a add, so int add, okay, now into the return type, add the function name of, okay, now int a comma b, those are argument list. Now coming to our function body, what is that? So a equal to 10, b equal to 20. Now c equal to a plus b. Print of something c, print of percentage d something c, and okay. Na? So like this. So simply these are all, okay, na? Aspects, these are all its syntaxes. Okay, this is about our aspects of our functions. Okay, now coming to our creating, how do we create a simple function in C language? Okay, na? The syntax shows how do we create a simple function in C language, that is return type function name of data type parameter open brace, okay, na? Code to be executed, end. So this is nothing but a simple function definition. This is nothing but simple function definition. Return type function name of data type parameter, okay, now open brace, close brace. In that, main logic is defined. Those class to be executed, okay, now this code to be executed. So simply, this is a simple syntax of function, okay, now. Coming to our next topic, that is inter-function communication in C language. Okay, inter-function communication in C language. This is our tomorrow's topic, and time is up. Okay, na? So I have next class at 9:30. So tomorrow's class is inter function communication. Now what we discuss in today's class, that is function definition. Next one is different types of functions. Those are a library functions and user defined functions. Next one, okay, na? Next one, advantages of functions. Come to our aspects of functions. Aspects are nothing but components of functions. And that is function declaration. Next one, function calling. And next one, function definition. These all are discussed with syntaxes. Okay, na? And next class, nothing but tomorrow's class, we will discuss about inter-function communication in C. Okay, na? Now you can log out and prepare for the next class. Thank you.